Sonny Donnelly, IFL TV in association with MGM Marbella. I'm here at the IES in Sheffield today and I'm with English super flyweight, is it?
Light flyweight
boxer, Harvey Horn. Harvey, see you training there today, obviously working hard. What have you been doing?
I've just come back from the World Championship, so it's sort of like ticking over training. No easy training, I would have chucked it straight back in the deep end, but it's sort of just polishing up on things that I got wrong in the world, so improving and getting ready for the next qualifier in April, I think it is.
What happened in the Worlds?
I drew the Indian's Commonwealth silver medalist first, Lashram, I think his name was, and I beat him 2-1. And after that, in the last 16, I had a Russian, the European champion who beat me in the Euros. I had him in the next round, so a tough draw, but I got beat again. But I think just had a bit of a stinker. I didn't turn up mentally, didn't turn up. I was physically ready, but I just had a bit of a stinker. But like I said, next time I know exactly what to do with him. So if I get him again, which I'm no doubt I will get him again, then it'll be a different story.
What's the sort of next comp coming up?
I'm not too sure. I think obviously the main one we're looking at is April. That's the European qualifier again. So there's another chance to qualify for Rio. But I'm sure we've got WSB starting in January. I think I've got one in America, maybe one in Mexico. And then I think a couple of little tournaments here and there just keeps ticking over until the big one.
Obviously in this sport it's always good to have competition. A little bit of competition on the podium potential is Sonny Edwards. I see you had a little bit of back and forth on Twitter about his ABA title and how you thought that he should, if he's not a real champion until he's beat you. What do you sort of think about that?
Yeah, I mean, well, I appreciate him saying that he's not a real champion until he's beat me, because obviously I won it the year before he won it. I couldn't go in it that year because I had international duties, but now he's on the development squad. He's obviously, he got a well-deserved place on the development squad. There's three good boys there now, Joe Mofosa, Sonny Edwards and Yafai. But I think, I'll be looking forward to sparring him and that, and I'm getting ready for them getting me ready for the qualifiers.
When is the qualifiers?
The first one's in April. Hopefully all goes well, that'll be the only one I need. But then there's two more after that. April, I think June, and then maybe July.
I see that obviously you can tell by his accent that he's not from Sheffield, he's not a local boy. You're from Essex. What's it like living down here in Sheffield?
It's different. It's different to Essex. I mean, I was originally out of East London, but now I'm in Essex. I mean, I've got used to it. You don't really see too much of Sheffield. You only see the gym and the track and the strength and conditioning gym.
Yeah.
But that's about it, yeah.
Is there a lot less fake tan?
A lot less fake tan, but I try and bring some with me.
Yeah, I know. I said that in the shower. I was like, you've been on the beds?
Oh, God, yeah. I like a bed.
You and Joe Cordina turning up. I thought you'd been to Mexico.
Cordina's a secret Essex boy, mate.
I know, he definitely is. I see he's always looking a bit bronze. Two bronze for Sheffield, I think.
Yeah.
But, go on. What's it like being with all the boys, obviously, like living together?
I enjoy it. It's like living with your pals and that. It's good, it is. It's definitely developed me. I'm only 20 myself and I'm a bit of a mummy's boy. I used to be mum doing everything for me. So being away, I've been on the squad for about a year now. It's got me used to fending for myself, cooking my own meals, managing myself properly.
Hey, and,
it's definitely done me a favour. Right, but
All right then, mate. Well, I know you want to get back to London. It's your last day here until next week, obviously. So I'll let you go. I don't want to keep you here longer. Best of luck in training. Best of luck in the European qualifiers and anything you do before that. And I'm sure I'll catch up with you soon.
Nice one. All right, top man. Right.